your baby boy would save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Jesus, come on somebody, amen.
For those of you who don't know us, we are Pastors Paul and Becky Steep. Gorgeosity is in the house, amen.
And she's so beautiful, doesn't she look beautiful?
We are so glad to have y'all tonight celebrating with us the best day ever, when Jesus Christ was born, amen. And if you don't know him tonight, you're going to have an opportunity to meet him. And we're going to have fun on the journey. Amen. As we get to that part, God is so good. And we're so glad that you, amen, all the time, that you took time out of your day to come and celebrate with us.
Amen. Amen. How many are ready to continue with some worship? Can I get an amen? Let's continue the journey with some worship. Amen.
Oh, come, let us adore.
Thank you. I love you, Jesus.
Now, I will say this. Those kids singing, man, I'm telling you, that don't jerk on your heartstrings. Come on. I tell you what. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful to know that we have kids that understand what Christmas is all about? Kids that say they love Jesus. They're not ashamed to sing to Jesus. They love coming to church. Come on, somebody. Amen. Man, that is just awesome, awesome. A next generation of preachers, a next generation of worship leaders, a next generation of people that we can pass the baton to that are going to continue to carry the light of Christ. Can I get an amen? Woo! Hallelujah. Good stuff. Good stuff. Tell your neighbor, Merry Christmas. Amen, amen. Becky and I would like to go ahead and just wish y'all a Merry Christmas. We won't see y'all on Christmas, but I know you guys will be enjoying some time with family and friends, and hopefully y'all brought some family tonight. And how many of you guys know we're going to choose joy, amen, this Christmas season? And we're going to remember what the season's all about. How many of you guys know that a king is born? And his name is Jesus. Tell your neighbor, I love Jesus. Say, I love Jesus. Come on, I love Jesus. Amen, amen. Well, this evening, I want to share with you on the subject of the star, but the star of light. The star of light. The star of light guided the wise men. It lit the night for the shepherds. It signaled the way for Emmanuel, God with us. And it announced the arrival of the bright morning star, Jesus, the light of the worlds. And so this morning, I want to share with you on two points, or this afternoon, or evening, which this is a special evening. You're going to enjoy it. Are y'all enjoying it so far? How many are enjoying the journey so far? Amen. But number one is this. Jesus is the true star of Christmas. He is the light of the world. And so we're going to go to John chapter 8, verse 12. I've been sharing this scripture throughout this series. And it says this, and Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. When you follow Jesus, how many of you guys know he will be a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path? When you follow Jesus, he will be your sunshine by day. How many of you guys know and your starlight by night? He will be a beacon of light so you always have light. And he will be an inner fire so you can be a light in a dark world. Can I get an amen? Come on, let's talk about the light of the world. His name is Jesus. And so the wise men, they followed the star to find the light of the world, Jesus. In Matthew chapter 2, verses 7 through 11, we find this. And it says this. It says in Herod, referring to the king, it says, and Herod called for a private meeting with the wise men, and he learned from them the time when the star first appeared. Then he told them, go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go and worship him too. Verse 9, after the interview, the wise men went their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. How many guys know the child is Jesus? The child is Jesus. That is the true. How many of you guys know that is the true star of Christmas? In verse 10, it says, when they saw the star. If you got your Bibles, you want to highlight that, underline that. So I'm going to be talking about when they saw the star. They were filled with joy. Remember, I've shared with you, how many guys know when you see Jesus for who he really is, Savior of the world, how many guys know it's going to bring you great joy? Great joy. In verse 11, then it says, I love this, it's powerful. It says, and then they entered the house, or they came into the house. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasure chest and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I love the fact that they saw the star. And I want you to know, when you follow God's light will always lead you back to him. And it led the wise men back to Jesus. But I want to show you this illustration, and I feel this will speak loudly also to the children in the room. The wise men did something, I believe, greater than just following the star. If y'all could give me the spotlight, cut the lights out for a second. Give me a tight light. Real tight light. Super tight. Over here. Real tight light. The light off of me. Tighter. Tight as y'all can get it. Y'all get it tighter? I'm trying to show this. I want the kids to get in on this. A lot of times this is what we think of. We think of the wise men following the light. But this is so much powerful than them following God's light. They followed the light to Jesus. They followed the light to Bethlehem. They followed the light to the place where Jesus was. How many guys know, number one, we should always follow the light, and the light's always going to lead us to places where Jesus is invited? Amen. But they did something so much more powerful in this. And the light is there, and they are out here, and they're following the light to Bethlehem. But I love the fact that when they came to the place, when they came to the house, they did something that was so powerful. They didn't stop there. Yeah, I said they stopped, but then they did something powerful. They entered in. So they followed the light, but then when they got to the place where Jesus was and they saw the star of Christmas, they entered into the light. And the Bible tells us that we're supposed to be in the light as He is in the light. And we're supposed to enter into that light, and they begin to worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and they surrendered their life to Him, and they entered into the light that first Christmas. Church, you and I need to be entering into the light every day. We can enter into the Word. How many guys know the light of His Word every day? We can enter into the light of His presence every day. We can enter in to an encounter with Jesus every single day of our life. And so we should follow God's light, but how many guys know we should be in the light as He is in the light? And we should enter into His presence, because His presence is with us. And that is the greatest gift ever given to mankind. The light of Christ, that first Christmas given to you and me. So Jesus is the true star of Christmas. And I don't know about you, I want to be in the light as He is in the light. And I want to live in the light every single day of my life. And the more I'm in the light, the less people see of me, and the more they see of Him. And I cannot reflect the glory of God if I'm not walking in the light of Christ. And as long as I'm entering in every single day, there ought to be a reflection of His glory in me. Y'all go and give me a hand. Y'all kick the lights off. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So my point number two is this. This is powerful. Watch this. The light will cause you to see what darkness tries to hide. Whoo, did y'all catch that? I'm going to say that again. The light will cause you to see what darkness tries to hide. How many guys know you can't hide Jesus? You can't hide the light. Come on, somebody. But watch this. Watch this. It's amazing to me. Watch this. I'm going to back up just a little bit. It's amazing how the first time the universe hears God's voice, they hear it say, "Let there be light." We go to Genesis chapter 1, the very first chapter, and we'll read from verses 1 through 3, and it says this: "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." Verse 2, "The earth was without form and void, and the darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters." In verse 3, "Then God said, let there be light. And there was light." He didn't say, "Let there be joy, let there be hope, peace, or love." He said, "Let there be what?" He said, "Let there be," come on, y'all help me. One more time. "Let there be what?" Light. Wanted to get the kids involved. Amen. Why? Why? Because it's the light. Tell your neighbor, it's the light. Why? Because it's the light that causes you to see the joy of Jesus. It's the light that, how many guys know, that would lay hands on the hope of the world? It's the light that will cause you to behold the Prince of Peace. And it's the light, how many guys know, that will cause you to know the love of God? It's all because of the light. And how many guys know darkness is constantly trying to hide the light? But how many of you guys know it couldn't hide the true star of Christmas, Jesus, the light of the worlds? And so when the wise men saw the light, they saw the very thing Herod, the King Herod, and the enemy didn't really. He said he'd come back to worship. How many guys, he wasn't going to worship him. He was going to kill him. And later on, you read about how an angel of light had to speak to Joseph and to speak to the wise men, because Herod was out to kill Jesus. And how many of you guys know that the enemy is constantly trying to kill the light in us? Constantly trying to diminish and to extinguish and to cause our light to go dim. But if you will stay in the light as he is in the light, how many of you guys know your light will continue to shine bright every single day? And I want you to know, if you stay in the light, how many of you guys know the bride of this world will become? The church is a city on a hill. A city on a hill. Tell your neighbor, we are the light of the world. We are the light that people are supposed to see. But they, how many of you guys know it's not us, but it's Christ in us? And when people look into darkness, they ought to be able to see visible lights. They ought to be see the light of Christ inside of you and me. This is what happened to the wise men. And I love the fact that they saw the light. And how many of you guys know light will allow us to see who God really is? Even faith, watch this, even faith needs light to see. Did y'all hear me? Even faith needs light to see. When you have light, how many of you guys know when faith has light? How many of you guys know faith needs light to see the invisible, to believe the impossible, and expect the incredible? Can I get an amen? So I'd like to close with this, John chapter 12, verse 46. And it says this, I love it. Jesus says, I have come as a light to shine in this dark world so that all, somebody say all, so that all who put their trust in me will no longer remain in the dark. That means when you follow the light and put your trust in Jesus, how many of you guys know he will light up your life? Amen. How many of y'all could testify that God has lit up your life? How many of y'all can testify how you're no longer walking in your dark ways, but now you're walking in the light of Christ? There are people in this room, listen to me, they were bound by different addictions. They were bound by darkness that was holding them back, dark thoughts. There's some of you in this room, because the light of Christ came into your life, you begin to see God for who he really was, for who he really is, and you forgot who you were. And you realize that you're not defined by your past. You're defined by what Jesus has done for you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So when you follow the light and you put your trust in Jesus, he will light up your life. In other words, how many guys know you will have faith that the impossible is always possible? You will have hope when it seems hopeless. You have peace through the storms of life. You have joy in the midst of circumstances. And you will have true love when you know the light of God's love. And how many of you guys know that's Jesus? Amen. I'll show you this last little illustration as I close. Can I see that candle? Now this candle I'm holding right here, it has the potential to give off light. It has the ability to give off light. But how many of you guys know this candle isn't light? The only way this candle can be lit is, number one, how many of you guys know it's got to have a power source? And number two, the switch has got to be turned on. And when I turn the switch on, it lights up. And I want to encourage and challenge you, and for some of the children that are in this room, this is that song we sing, This Little Light of Mine, I'm going to Let It Shine. I don't know about you. When you put all these little lights together, it makes a big light, which we're about to see in our candlelight service. But this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. And I'm not going to allow life, pressure, circumstances, challenges to cause me to turn the switch off. I'm going to leave the light on. Tell your neighbor, I'm going to leave the light on. I'm going to leave the light on. I'm going to leave the light on. But even if I leave the light on, how many of you guys know sooner or later the battery is going to die and the light's going to go out? But if I keep the battery charged, how many of you guys know it's not going to go out? One thing that's so amazing about Jesus, how many of you guys know he's a power source that will constantly supply power to our life so we can stay lit for Jesus Christ every single day? How many of you guys got cell phones in here? I promise you, I'm closing. Get your cell phones out. Get your cell phones out. How many of y'all got cell phones? Dim the lights for me a little bit. Everybody got a cell phone? Y'all know I like to pull cell phones out of candlelight service. Who got a cell phone? All right, turn your cell phone on. How many got flashlights on your cell phones? Y'all go ahead, turn the flashlight on. Some of y'all say, Pastor, I'm down to 5%. You got to hurry up. You got to hurry up. Hurry up, Pastor. I'm 5%, 5%. That's why you in church. You're about to get a charge. Can I get an amen? Come on, somebody. Come on. Amen. Yeah, light it up. Light it up. Light it up. Y'all got to turn them on. Light it up. Light it up. Some of y'all say, I'm believing God for a cell phone for Christmas. That's good. Keep believing. Just don't take your neighbors when you leave. Come on. God is your source. He's your provider. All right, now I want y'all to lift them up in the air like this. Look at that. That looks beautiful. Somebody give me a picture of this. Amen. Amen. How many of you guys know this is how we're supposed to live our life every single day? We're supposed to live lit every single day, allowing our light to shine bright. How many of you guys know we're not supposed to be ashamed and hide it? We're not supposed to live in this kind of, kind of put it behind our back like this or stick it in our pocket. How many of you guys know we're supposed to be proud? The Bible says that they followed the star that was eastward. That word east means to arise. And I'm here to tell you, church, listen to me, it's time for us to arise. It's time for us to arise and take the light of Christ and shine bright for him every single day. And listen to me, we don't have to turn the light off, even though you're going to have to turn your cell phone off in a minute. We don't have to turn the light off. We need to continue to shine. And maybe you're in here and you say, Pastor, I don't have a cell phone. That's okay. You can still have Jesus. Can I get an amen? You can still have Jesus. But there's one challenge I have for you, because the new year's coming up, and here's my challenge to you. My challenge is to you is to don't allow anything to turn the lights off. Nothing to turn the lights off. Keep the lights on. The world only gets dark when the lights are turned off. And we're going to keep the lights on. In our homes, come on, and at our jobs, in our schools, come on, somebody. In our marriage, ooh, come on, husbands right there. I just helped you out again, and y'all didn't. I'm going to do that again. In our marriages, come on, all right, there you go. You got an extra gift now for Christmas just because of me. Amen, amen. We're going to leave the lights on, church. We're going to leave the lights on. Yeah. Y'all go ahead and leave them on as I close. We'll kick them off in just a second. Listen to me, if you're in here, I'm going to get serious for a moment. If you're in here, and you say, Pastor, my light's gone dim. Maybe your light's gone dim. Maybe you know, you say, Pastor, I've never surrendered my life to Jesus. And if I were to leave this building today, and if I were to die, I don't know where I'd spend eternity. I want you to know that Jesus said that if you call upon the name of the Lord, you will be saved. If you put your faith and trust in him, that you will have salvation, that you will spend eternity with him forever and ever and ever. And so maybe you're in here and you say, I'm backslidden, Pastor, that's me. You call me out. Listen to me. No, it wasn't me. It was Jesus. He's speaking to you right now. So if that's you, I want to pray for you. You say, Pastor, that's me. I need to surrender my life to Christ. Because I want you to know that's what the wise men did. They gave three gifts, but they gave a fourth gift, and the fourth gift was their lives. When they bowed down to worship him, they surrendered their life to Jesus. So I believe there's some of you in here tonight as we celebrate the reason for the season, which is Jesus. This is your moment. This is your time to get your heart right with God and to surrender your life to him. If that's you, let me pray with you. Can I see your hand? Can I see your hand? Y'all lift your hands. Y'all can turn the lights up. Y'all can turn your phones off. Get your hands up. Y'all get your hands up. Anybody else? I see your hands. I see your hands. I see the kids. I see your hands. I see your hands. I see your hands. Everyone say, Dear Lord, tonight I surrender my life to you. Come into my life. Make me new and help me to live for you. Every day in every way, Lord, I receive your love, your grace, and your forgiveness. I believe I'm heaven bound in Jesus' name. Amen. Y'all give them a hand. Hallelujah.
Love incarnate, love divine. Star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee. The Savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born. He shall reign some.